What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Welcome to the fourth tutorial in PL SQL Ref Cursor series. So far, we have learned how to create a strong ref cursor using table-based record data type and user-defined record data type. Today, we will learn how to create a weak ref cursor in Oracle database. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. Unlike the strong ref cursor, a ref cursor which does not have a fixed return type is called a weak ref cursor. Because weak ref cursors do not have a fixed return type, thus they are open to all types of select statements. This also makes them most frequently used ref cursors in comparison to others. Now let's jump on to the tutorial and do some examples. But before that, if you enjoy watching this tutorial, then do make sure to subscribe and like the video. Now let's write the example. Here is the declaration section of our code. In the first line, after the declare keyword, we have declared our weak ref cursor with the name wk_refcur. As you can see, this time we do not have any return type associated with this ref cursor. Right below this, in the second line, we have declared our cursor variable of ref cursor type. Apart from cursor variable, we have also declared two extra variables f_name and emp_sal. Both these variables are of anchor data type and are based on the first name and salary column of the employees table. We will use both these variables to hold the data which will be fetched into the weak ref cursor. Now let's write the execution section. Just like the previous two tutorials, the execution section is pretty simple. In this section, we again have four statements. Let's have a look. Statement 1, the open for statement. Using this statement, we are opening our weak ref cursor for the select statement, which is returning the data of the employee whose employee ID is 100 from the first name and salary column of employees table. Statement 2, the fetch statement. Using this statement, we are fetching the data from the cursor into the variables f_name and emp_sal. Statement 3, the close statement. Closing a cursor that you are done with is a good practice. Statement 4, the output statement. The fourth and the last statement of the execution section is DBMS output statement, which is displaying back the data fetched using ref cursor and retrieved into both the anchor data type variables. With these four statements, we sum up the code for our weak ref cursor. Let's execute this code and see the result. Here we are. As you can see, we used the weak ref cursor to retrieve the data of two different data types from two different columns of a table. This wouldn't have been possible with a strong ref cursor because of its fixed return type, unless we had created it using the user-defined record data type. That is a very simple example just to show you how to create and work with a PL SQL weak ref cursor in Oracle database. Hope this helped you in learning the basics of weak ref cursor. For more in-depth knowledge, please refer to the blog post on the same topic. Link is in the description. Please do like the video and subscribe to the channel, as in the next tutorial we will learn what are sys ref cursors. That being said, let's wind up. Thanks for watching. This is the tutorial on how to create PL SQL weak ref cursor in Oracle database by your friend Manish from RebellionRider.com. Thanks for watching.